In this video, we'll learn how to complete the square. With completing the square, it's important to remember that if x squared equals 9, then there are two solutions for x. There's 3, so if x is 3, it would be x times x, which is 9, and the option of negative 3 as well, because if we square negative 3, we get 9 as well. We can write this as plus or minus 3. To complete the square on ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0, we have to follow 3 steps. The first one is separate numbers. And variables. In this case, the variable is c. Next, we divide by a. When we divide all the terms by a. Thirdly, we find this new c using the formula and add to both sides. I think this will make more sense once we try example 1. In example 1, we first need to separate the numbers and variables. We do this by adding 6 to both sides. When we add 6 to both sides, we get x squared minus x is equal to 6. Notice I'm leaving a placeholder right here. This will become important in just a minute. Number 2, we divide by a. A is the coefficient in front of x squared. Notice the coefficient is 1 right now, and so we don't have to divide by 1 because nothing would change. In example 2, we'll have something other than 1. It'll be a 3, and then we will have to divide. Next, we find c. Notice c is missing, and that's why I left a placeholder there. C is now equal to 1/2 of b, which happens to be a negative 1, squared. So c is equal to 1/2, and that's negative, because negative 1 times 1/2 is negative 1/2, squared, which gives me positive 1/4. So 1/4 is now c. Here's where it gets interesting. Notice that in part 3, we're told to add to both sides. So whatever I add to the left side of my equation, I'm also going to add to the right side of my equation. So now I get x squared minus x plus 1/4 is equal to 6 plus 1/4. I need to find a common denominator. So I build up 6 to 24/4 plus 1/4. Now I have x squared minus x plus 1/4 is equal to 25/4. I can factor my perfect square trinomial on the left to x minus 1/2 squared. And on the right, I still have 25/4. So if I take the square root of both sides, I'm going to have x minus 1/2 is equal to plus or minus 5/2. This is not completely done yet because I haven't isolated x, so I need to add 1/2 to both sides. So I get x is equal to 1/2 plus or minus 5/2. So my options are x is equal 1/2 plus 5/2, which is equal to 6/2, or just 3 when reduced, or x is equal to 1/2 minus 5/2, which is equal to negative 4/2, or just negative 2. So these are my two solutions for x. In example 2, we see that we have 3x squared is equal to 15x minus 18. Notice in example 1, everything was set to 0 originally. So we need to get c on the right side of the equation and all the other terms on the left side. So I'm going to subtract 15x from both sides. This gives me 3x squared minus 15x is equal to 18. In step 2, we need to divide everything by the leading coefficient of the x squared term. This gives us x squared minus 5x equal to negative 6. Next, I need to find c. C is equal to 1/2 negative 5. Squared, which gives me negative 5/2 squared, which equals 25/4. Now I'm going to rewrite my perfect square trinomial as x squared minus 5x plus c, which is 25/4. And that's equal to negative 6 plus 25/4. Remember that whatever I add to the left side of the equation, I also have to add to the right side. Building up my denominator, I'm going to have this factor to x minus 5/2 squared equal to negative 24/4, now that I've made that denominator match, plus 25/4. Taking the square root of both sides to solve for x gives me x minus 5/2 is equal to the square root of 1/4, which is equal to plus or minus 1/2. Adding 5/2 to both sides, I get 5 plus 1, plus or minus 1 over 2. So x is equal to 6/2 or 2/4, which reduces to 3 or 2.